Seeing a fireboat display such impressive and drenching power is a real treat. Watching a fireboat turn 50 years old is rare. Put these together, throw in the rest of the FDNY Marine Company boats, and you've just seen the most extraordinary deluge of water that only luck would bring in a lifetime. The display marks 50 brilliant years of service from the boat John D. McKean of Marine Company 1, located on the Hudson River in New York City. On September 17, 1953, John D. McKean was below decks of the fireboat George B. McClellan.
On that September day, he was called upon to put his life in harm's way to save the lives of that entire crew of the McClellan. He stayed at that post holding back the steam, and the steam, when it exploded, cost John his life.
At the time of the accident, a new, state-of-the-art boat was being built. There was no name yet chosen for the fireboat, and that honor would be placed on John's name. On September 9, 1954, the fireboat John D. McKean sailed into New York Harbor. Presently, the McKean resides at its quarters at Marine Company 1. A boat of 50 years requires more than mere maintenance. The crew is constantly keeping the boat in great shape, a full-time job. A team from Maine arrived in New York City 2 weeks before the 50-year anniversary celebration. They volunteered to repaint the emblem on the smokestack and strip and polish the forward deluge cannon. At first glance, you can immediately tell that Marine One has a lot of character. As soon as they arrive, the main crew is ready to get to work, knowing that they have a long job ahead of them. McKean was stationed at the Brooklyn Navy Yard, a 15-minute boat ride away from quarters.
I want to wake up in a city that doesn't sleep and find I'm king of the hill, top of the heap. These little town blues.
The crew waste no time heading straight to work, knowing each minute is valuable since they will only have 3 days to strip the gun and paint the emblem. Andy Swift and Andy Pelletier from Maine volunteered to scrape the water cannon.
I told people you're here and that you're here to help us out, and they said that they'll do what they can, but they said you should have power here. You should have air conditioning. Okay. Everything you need is on here.
All right.
And anything that you do need, don't hesitate to call. You got our number back?
The Marine Company was more than accommodating to the Maine workers.
This is the boat.
Now the only thing left to do was work, work, work.
And I've been taking care of business every day. Taking care of business every way. I've been taking care of business. It's all mine. Taking care of business and working overtime. What else?
Drew needs food, and boy, did they get it.
If I can make two meatballs a man. No, I gotta put sauce in it, kid. Don't take it yet. Come on, Steve, man. You don't even know what smoke smells like. You know what cigarette smoke smells like.
He knows what fat is. Like. He watched the Yule log on
TV. We'll give him another one.
What are you, like, Magic Man, a meatball? That guy's only got one.
He's got two of them. Honestly, man.
Get out of the way, boss.
Hey, we got something good on it?
What do we got? Who's sitting here?
I got something to drink. There's glasses. There's something I can't. Got iced tea, lemonade, whatever you like.
Four of you guys?
Yeah.
After a huge meal, it's finally time to get some shut-eye.
Four couches for you, okay?
okay?
All right.
The crew gets up and moving early in an effort to beat the afternoon heat.
Now, to see how far we get in 3 days.
Peter Acorn from Tennant's Harbor, Maine, is a sign painter. He volunteered to repaint the emblem.
Paint's real old, chalky. Concerned about my new paint sticking to the old paint.